Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome to my channel Psychology Facts by Lara. So viewers, I am here with the part 4 of this series and it is the last part of SOAR GRE practice test, and here is a soft reminder before moving forward to the MCQs that please subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you can get latest updates. And now let's move towards the MCQs. Number 153, the anti-anxiety effects of benzodiazepines such as diazepam result from their binding with the receptor of which of the following neurotransmitters found in amygdala? The anti-anxiety effects of benzodiazepines, as benzodiazepines is used to treat anxiety, and particularly diazepam basically work with the neurotransmitter that is found in amygdala is gamma-aminobutyric acid, that is known as GABA. And it's basically the drug basically attach or bind with the receptors of GABA that is located in amygdala to treat anxiety effects. Number 154. The fact that Laura still knows how to ride a bicycle even though she hasn't ridden one in 10 years best exemplifies which of the following types of memory. This memory is known as procedural memory. Number 155, a persistent, unreasonable and unwanted thought is known as an obsession. Number 156, which of the following distinguishes experts from novices in many fields of endeavor? The right option is speed in recognizing relevant complex patterns. As the term novices indicates, the person who is new to any field or who is inexperienced in that particular field. And the fields of endeavor is a field where hard work is required. So the experts who are doing a job at a particular area or a particular field will be more competent and they will recognize the relevant complex patterns more accurately and more speedily than novices. So here the right option is speed in recognizing relevant complex patterns. Number 157, Randy is exceptionally organized. For example, he color codes all his bills, alphabetizes the grocery in his cupboard. According to Freud's theory, Randy is most likely fixated at which state of psychosexual development? The right option is anal, as anal state is the second state of psychosexual development, and when fixation occur at this stage, two types of personalities usually develop, or anal retentive and anal exclusive personalities. And in anal retentive, person become too stubborn, too stingy and focuses on perfectionism. So here overall scenario indicates that Randy is exceptionally organized and he is fixated at anal state. Number 158, which of the following psychological school of thought was heavily influenced by pragmatism? Pragmatism is basically an aspect or perspective that we must focus on practical applications of theories rather than its ideas. So functionalism was the school of thought that has focused or that has that was more or heavily influenced by pragmatism concept. Number 159, consider the diagram above in which the outcomes for two people, John and Malik, are represented as a series of numbers. Depending on their own behavior and the behavior of other persons, a scientist uses these outcomes to predict the likely behavior of each of the individuals. The scientist is most likely studying which of the following? As first of all, we have to see the diagram. The diagram over indicates the outcome of John that are represented in white and the outcomes of Malik that are represented in gray. So first of all, when they cooperate each other, their relationship is very good. This first stage indicates that they are cooperating with each other, and when Malik doesn't want to cooperate so he wanted to compete, the relationship faces several issues. And the next stage indicates that John also don't want to cooperate with Malik. So as a result is they both abandon their relationship. So overall we can say that the scientist is most likely to studying social exchange theory, and this theory was given by George Homans. And according to George Homans, if a person is in any relationship, find out that the relationship is not useful and does not give any sort of reward, and both person basically measures the benefits of the relationship, And when the relationship basically outweigh the risks rather than rewards, they both abandon the relationship. So this is known as social exchange concept or social exchange theory. Number 160, who is reported to be the first researcher to utilize a twin study methodology in attempting to resolve the nature-nurture controversy? Francis Galton. Number 161, eliciting sympathy in order to create positive impression is consistent with which of the following self-presentation strategy? Exemplification is the self-presentation strategy in which person tried to create a good impression by portraying his or herself as more self-sacrificing, more empathetic and sympathetic. So it's most consistent with this statement. Number 162, which of the following statements describe normative influence? The right option is conformity motivated by the belief that others are correct, and in normative influence, persons usually try to conform due to the expectations of others, and he basically wanted to gain acceptance. So the right option is option E. Number 163, a group of researchers was interested in learning whether a newly developed exam would be useful in determining whether the student will be successful in the college. The researcher designed a study in which students took the new exam prior to entering the college. At the conclusion of the first year of college, the student took another exam, which was designed to measure how much information they had learned during their first year of college. So the score on this exam was then correlated with the student's scores on the newly developed exam. What type of validity was being evaluated in this study? So the first statement indicates that the researcher was interested in determining whether the students will be successful in the college or not. So they want to assess the future of their students, whether they are going to be successful or not. So this indicates predictiveness. So overall, we can say that the study is more focused on evaluating the predictive validity. So the right option is option B, predictive validity. And here we can see that two tests or two exams has been taken. The first exam was taken prior to the college, which means that the researcher was interested to understand the level of their knowledge or education prior to entering the college. And the second exam has taken after the 1 year of study, and this indicates that how much they have learned throughout the first year. So these results or outcomes of these results or score of these results were then correlated to understand how much they have learned throughout the year or how much information they had before entering the college. So overall, this scenario or this study is evaluating the predictive validity, and the right option is B, predictive validity. Number 164, which of the following hormones is responsible for preparing the uterus for the implantation of ovum that has been fertilized? Progesterone. Number 165, an adolescent who says, "I won't become ill from smoking, I never get sick," is most likely operating under which aspect of egocentrism? The right option is personal fable, in which person usually thinks that whatever he is thinking is the right one, and he makes his own stories, his own beliefs about particular thing. Number 166, Alfred Adler developed his theory of individual psychology as a result of disagreement with which of the following? The right option is B, Sigmund Freud. Sigmund Freud basically has emphasized on the universal biological factors. He has emphasized on universal biological factors in the personality, and on contrary, Alfred Adler has focused on individual psychology. So we can say that there was a disagreement between Alfred Adler and Sigmund Freud's concepts or theories. So that's why he has developed his own theory that is known as individual psychology. Number 167, which of the following school of psychology rejected the concept of consciousness and defined psychology as an objective natural science? The right option is behaviorism. Number 168, which of the following is a memory store that is highly sensitive to masking stimuli presented within 200 to 300 milliseconds of the presentation of an array of letters? The right option is sensory memory. Number 169, the neural hub of the central executive portion of working memory is thought to be located in the prefrontal cortex. In an experimental procedure, an animal receives a half second of food shock at the first, then half second of new stimulus, and then a tone. And afterwards, in later presentations of the tone, the animal displays a fear response. So this result is most likely indicates the occurrence of backward conditioning. Number 171. In what way does delirium differ from dementia? The right option is delirium is a temporary state and whereas dementia is a permanent state. Number 172. The full moon looks much larger when it is on the horizon than when it is high in the sky. Which of the following is the best explanation for this phenomena? This statement indicates basically moon illusion, and it is still in debate that why moon looks much larger on the horizon and why it looks smaller higher in the sky, and it debate still continues, but some scientists has answered this phenomena in this way that it is basically our brain that perceive the moon size as much larger, but in reality the moon never becomes smaller when it is near the horizon. It's the brain that is perceiving it in this way. So the right option is option B. Size judgment is based on visual cues between the viewer and the image of the moon. Number 173. When newborn baby Yasmin's cheek is stroked, she turns her head in the direction of the stimulus. Which reflex is Yasmin demonstrating? The right option is rooting reflex. Number 174. Which of the following philosophers insisted that mind at birth is like a blank slate devoid of character or ideas? The right option is John Locke. Number 175. On his first date with Sue, Bill walks into a party, trips coming through the doorway and falls flat on the floor. So here overall actions of the Bills I indicated in this statement that he basically trips from the doorway and fall flat on the door. And what his attribution is, he thinks that the floor is uneven, that's why he has fallen. And Sue on contrary thinks that the Bill is very clumsy boy. And there are different attributions that are presented in their personality, and how they are attributing indicate which sort of attribution. This is known as actor-observer bias, and in actor-observer bias, when persons do anything, he thinks that it's basically the external causes are doing this. So that's why the Bill basically thinks that there must be an uneven floor that is causing or that is making him trip, and on contrary, Sue is thinking that Bill is probably clumsy. So here he is indicating that it is the external cause that's why Bill is showing this behavior. So this overall scenario indicates the attribution vector observer bias. Number 176. The over-justification effect states which of the following? The right option is option B. Extrinsic rewards can diminish children's intrinsic motivation to learn, and this overall concept is known as over-justification effect. Number 177. The belief that differences among spoken languages cause differences in the thinking and problem-solving styles of speakers is called the Sapir-Whorf hypothesis. And these two persons has given this hypothesis, and it is based. Number 178. Volunteers are trying to get people to donate money to a charity. Which of the following is the example of foot in the door principle? Ask people to donate only $1. If they accept, ask them to donate $10. This indicates foot in the door phenomena. Number 179. Which of the following is correct sequence of stage of prenatal development? The right option is D. Fertilized ovum, embryo and fetus. 180. Participants in a social psychological experiment observe through a one-way glass as two students take an oral quiz. The situation is arranged in such that both Arthur, the name of the student, and Sherry, There is also a student get 15 out of 25 questions correct. So the statement indicates that both author and Sherry gets 15-15 correct answers. Basically, they give 15 correct answers out of 25. But author gets each of the first 5 questions correct. As it was an oral quiz and it was pre-planned that author is going to answer the first 5 questions correct while Sherry gets none of the first 5 questions correct. So most participants observers would likely to conclude that author is better student than Sherry because here he answers the first 5 questions correct while Sherry answers the last 5 questions correct. So overall the observation is based on the first one who gets the right answer at the first. So they think that author is the best student than Sherry. Number 181. Which of the following is a characteristic of the authoritarian personality? Hostility towards outgroup. Number 182. The confirmation bias leads people to draw incorrect conclusions because they do not seek evidence that would disapprove their hypothesis. Number 183. Dr. Wang is a theorist who is interested in how a given behavior increases an organism's chance of reproductive success and perpetuates the species. Dr. Wang is most likely an evolutionary psychologist. Number 184. In his study of schizophrenia, Dr. Perez collects the data on the number of new cases of this diagnosis in the United States in the past year. This statistic is known as incidence. Number 185. A security screener in an airport checks everything by hand. That seems suspicious. It is critical that she never let any potentially dangerous item through her security checkpoint. In terms of signal detection theory, this screener is likely to make a large number of hits and large number of false alarms. As the security screener is checking everything by hand, that indicates that he's going to check everything that is suspicious. So basically, there would be large number of hits, which means that whenever he is going to check the thing that is suspicious, there must be that suspicious thing present. And there must be large chances that he's going to check any item or anything that is not suspicious, but it seems suspicious to him. So there are going to be large number of hits and large number of false alarms. So the right option is option B. Number 186. The Premack principle states that a more frequent behavior will reinforce a less frequent behavior. Number 187. Elizabeth Loftus and her colleagues ask the students to talk about various events that have been occurred in their lives, including one that has never occurred. And if the students have trouble remembering the event, the researcher provide certain cues to them. They record whether the students remember the events that never occurred and how confident the students are in the false memory. So which of the following best describe the findings? Overall, the scenario indicates that Elizabeth Loftus and her colleagues are interested to assess overall students' memory, student memories, and about how, if we are going to give certain cues to them about any event that has not taken place in their past, but how they are going to respond and how much confident the students are about that particular event and how much confident about their false memories. So the right option here is about 25% of students remember the false event and many are quite confident in it. So that indicates that sometimes when providing certain cues, people used to generate some false memories relating to that cue, and they become much confident on that memory as well. Number 188. Melvin has a set of worn fray hairs of different diameters. He starts by pressing a thin hair against a participant's toe and continues with increasingly thicker hair until the participants feel pressure. Melvin then starts with a thick hair and uses increasingly thinner hairs until the participant does not feel pressure. Melvin is using a method of limits. Number 189, long-term potentiation is widely assumed to be the physiological mechanism of learning. Number 190, a psychologist wishes to compare the performances of an experiment group and control group on a continuous measure. Which of the following would be the most typical way of way to make the comparison? The right option is conducting a t-test on the two means. Number 191, we process information relevant to the self more efficiently than we process other type of information. This phenomena is called the self-reference effect. Number 192, every time he hears the name of his favorite restaurant, Jacobs begins to salivate. In Pavlovian terms, the restaurant's name is serving as a conditioned stimulus. Number 193, which of the following is a type of glial cell that is responsible for producing the myelin sheaths that cover axon? The right option is oligodendrocyte. Number 194, Roberta lives on the first floor of her dorm. She notices that she has made more friends with the others who live on her floor than with others on the other floors. This is an example of propinquity. Number 195, some researchers believe that people acquire a second language better if they learn it prior to the adolescence, while other researchers believe that people can easily learn most aspects of second language even if they are beyond adolescence. However, after particular research or after particular or frequent observations, limitation in second language use were prominent, and both groups would expect to observe less than native-like competencies. So they were prominent, less competencies were observed as compared to native speakers and after the adolescence. So which of the following is more points where we can say that limitation that has been seen in this research, it is basically the pronunciation. 196. The legal requirement that professionals notify appropriate authorities about suspected child abuse is known as mandatory reporting. So question number 197 to 199 refers to the following information. So here is a study. In a study of new psychopharmacological treatment for clinical depression, 40 participants diagnosed with depression each received 4 different amounts of medication. Each received 4 different amounts of new medication that was known as Deplo. The first week they were given a placebo. Remember that the first week they were given a placebo. During the second week of the study, they took 1 mg of Deplo each day. During the third week, they took 3 mg of Deplo each day, and during fourth week, they took 5 mg of Deplo each day. Although the participants took different amounts of medication each week, they were not informed about the amount they were taking. They were not informed about the amount they were taking. So, the participants also completed a depression symptom checklist at the end of each week. The results are presented here, and the score on the checklist could range from 0 to 30. 0 indicates no depression and 30 indicates severe depression. Assume statistical significance for differences greater than 3.0. So here is a graph that indicates, or here is a overall chart that indicates the treatment weeks. Number one week or the first week, they were given placebo and the score was 22, and on second week they were given 1 mg Deplo, and that was a new medication, and on third they were given 3 mg and fourth week they were given 5 mg. So the results indicates that there was a decrease in depression, as it is 14. The highest one is 30, and at the 4 week they has shown the depression score 14.5. So the statement indicates that which of the following effect is most serious limitation of this study? The right option is carryover. So the right option of MCQ number 197 was carryover, and carryover is a effect that basically happens in a research type in which researcher uses the same participants, and these participants are exposed to all different experimental treatments, and the results are compared across different treatments. So this was the main limitation of this study. Number 198, what type of design was used in this study? Single factor within subjects. Number 199, which of the following would make it difficult to conclude that any decrease in depressive symptoms is due to Duplo and not to other aspects of the study? As there was lack of control group, so we cannot say it properly and assuredly that any results or any change in the symptoms of the depression is due to the medicine Duplo. Number 200, conducting a study by analyzing United States census data from previous year is an example of using which of the following research approach? This is known as archival analysis. Number 201, Dr. Chen is interested in feminist attitude of young adult women in United States. Consequently, she administered a feminist attitude questionnaire to a total 100 young adult women from three different universities. And the 100 young women tested, the 100 young women that tested and the number of young adult women in the US are which of the following? As the 100 women that are tested are known as sample, and number of young adult women that are present in United States is population. So the right option is option C, sample and population. Number 202, which of the following are two individuals credited the founding of psychology as indicated by the formation of psychology laboratories in 1870s? The right option is Wilhelm Wundt and William James. Number 203, which of the following best describes the role of arousal in the proposed diagram depicting causal relationship among viewing violent television arousal and aggressive behavior? Here, violent television show arousal and then aggressive behavior. So that indicates mediating variable. Number 204, an action that a person does for no external reward that intentionally benefits another person is an example of which of the following concept? This is known as pure altruism. Number 205, that is the last one, which of the following best supports the all or none phenomena of neural impulses? The right option is a neuron will fire a complete action potential once the threshold is reached. That is known as all or none phenomena. And that brings us to the end of the video. Don't forget to watch part 1, part 2, and part 3 of this video. Thank you for watching.